required. If you had faith to find the mustard seed, you could say that mulberry tree, the uprooted plant of seed, and it would fade. Who among you would say to your slave who had just come in from plowing or tending the sheep in the field, come here at once and take your place to the field? Would you not rather say to him, prepare supper for him, put on your apron, and serve you all that you can drink? Do you thank the slave for doing what was commanded? So you also, when you have done all that you were ordered to do, say, we are worthless slaves. We have done only what we ought to have done. The gospel of our Lord. He works today. We have only done what we ought. The 10th verse, the last half of it, we have only done what we ought to have done. We have only done what we ought to have done. How many times, I'm just like trying to go back in my head here, I know that the problem of the list of the times that I've done the things that I shouldn't have done far outweigh the times that I've had done the things that I ought to have done. Anybody else? But we've only done what we ought to have done. Now, the context of today's scripture is very, very important. Because if you heard the pause when I first began reading the gospel message today, it was the apostles that said to the Lord, increase our faith. Well, show us how to increase our faith. We need some help to increase our faith. And so one of the things that we do in Bible study on Wednesday is we take a look and we see that. We want to ask the question, what would the Lord mean if we didn't say that? And so we go back to Luke 17, verse 1 to 4. Jesus said to his disciples, things that cause people to trip and to fall into sin must happen, but how terrible it is for the person through whom they happen. It would be better for them to be thrown into the lake with a large stone thrown around their neck, right, than to cause one of these little ones to trip and to fall into sin. The precipitations are coming. Temptations are coming. The opportunity to fall into sin is coming. And however, how horrible it will be for those who cause the little ones or these young Christians, these new disciples in Jesus Christ, to fall into sin. This is what they're hearing. Watch yourself. goes on. He's talking about this mulberry tree. Oh, mulberry tree. He can say it's a mulberry tree. Hey, mulberry tree. You know? I think I used an example in class this week. You go out with this. The disciples said, help us increase our faith. Well, number one, apostles, disciples of Jesus Christ, your faith is meant to grow. It is a faith that you move a mulberry tree or the oak tree or whatever other tree you want to choose today. But faith, that type of faith, is what helps us with the power to overcome temptation. Remember the first of the chapter. If you have been roller skating, do you know what roller skates are? Remember going to the roller skating rink and you park in youth group or something like that, church group, or just open skate nights, right? And they have these little different things during the course of the evening that you would play, right? One of them was the limbo. Remember the limbo? You know, doing the limbo, you know, they had the crazy limbo music, you know, they did that.
Pull it back out. We might put the other foot in, it's a generosity, but we just yank it right back out.
put your whole self in it. And you shake it all about. You do the Holy Ghost, you turn yourself around, that's what you're about. You don't put the end of that piece, you don't put yourself out. You're in. But if we're not striving and taking personal responsibility to give all in for Jesus through our discipleship, not just parts, every now and then, but our whole self. Doing what we are called. Good or whole self in. Effort, all the work. Today is a great moment. Take your right foot in, take your right foot out, escape the cat, and you end up heading the other direction. When you can stay here like I was. Always so profound. The pressure of the night is to do all the right things. The pressure of the end of the sense and keep the root and keep the sense. Wasn't that? Wasn't that? Don't do the same thing. You don't have to be a member of the church if you have nothing. Christ and rewarded life to his table all who love him. Who have earnestly repented their sin and seek to live in peace with one another. Therefore, let us confess our sin before God and one another. Merciful God, we confess that we have not loved you with our whole heart. We have failed to be in peace with you. We have not sinned before. We have worked in the law. Here's the good news. Christ died for us without any of our sins. That proves God's love toward us. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven. Glory to God. Amen. Join with me in the great thanksgiving. The Lord be with you. Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right, the good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, God Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. And so with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Thank you.
I believe in God the Father Almighty, the Maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day He rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence He shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit. Forgiveness of sin, the resurrection of life,
Thank you.